Roger, the actual impact of this thing is not being felt there on the market. If anything, it's being felt in commodities. It's being felt on the trading floors in Chicago at the Mercantile. That's where it's being felt. That's where Ali Velshi is going to be joining us in just a little bit. What does that have to do with you, you may be asking? I'll tell you what it has to do with you. It has everything to do with whether you can now buy a car or maybe get another house or get credit on a credit card. That's what that we're going to be talking about. We're going to be joining Ali in just a little bit. By the way, I want to share something with you. This thing, and we talked about it yesterday, and this is a very important point to make as we progress with this story. Remember, this thing started, give me a shot here. This thing started with this many pages. 3 pages is how this started, this bailout or rescue bill. This is what it is now, 450 pages. So obviously, any journalist worth his salt would ask, three, now 450? How do we get from that to here? What is contained in here that you, as taxpayers, need to know about? We did a little homework today here at CNN, and we found out. What it contains is wind power, solar power, disaster victims, college students, teachers, NASCAR racetrack owners, film producers, bicycle commuters, makers of Puerto Rican rum, makers of Virgin Islands rum, owners of plug-in electrical vehicles, investors in American Samoa, mine rescuers, worsted wool fabric producers, Alaskan fishermen, and makers of wooden arrows. Ron Paul joining us now to let us know what he thinks of this bill as we look at it. That, Congressman, is a heck of a lot of pork, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure is. It's pretty amazing. You take a bad bill and make it a lot worse, and you get 57 members of Congress switching from no to yes. So that tells you something about Washington. There's really not much hope for us here in D.C. to solve the problems, because it's just more of the same, more of the spending. You know, they're dealing with this. There is a financial crisis and a credit crunch, but they're not dealing with the fact that this country is bankrupt. And we're on the verge of some really major events, but we're adding fire to the fuel there. We're just dumping kerosene on it and making this problem that much worse. If debt is a problem, just think of what we've just done today. We have ballooned the debt like never before, putting more pressure on the Federal Reserve to monetize this debt and print more money. So expect a lot more inflation in the future.
Do you think there was a reasonable alternative for this?
Oh, absolutely. Doing nothing would have been a reasonable alternative. But a reasonable alternative would have been to give some tax breaks and also regulate the Federal Reserve, the Exchange Stabilization Fund, the President's Working Group on Financial Markets. They need regulated because they're working behind the scenes all the time to satisfy and take care of their friends and buddies. So those are the kind of regulations we do need. But we should be enforcing contracts, not canceling out contracts like they are doing, you know, in the mortgage market. But the most important thing that we should not be doing, and that is to prop up bad debt and malinvestment, because that only prolongs the agony and makes our problems that much worse.
Do you think that a lot of the politicians, and I hate to use that word, but it's the one that many Americans use when they look at you guys there in Washington, really got this thing, really understood it? Because I got to tell you, this is a really complicated deal, perhaps as complicated as anything that's ever been passed, right?
No, I don't think they have the vaguest idea what's in the bill and what it does and the unintended consequences. But you know, Warren Buffett said he had no really good understanding of the derivatives market, and that's why he stayed away from them. So if he has trouble understanding them, can you imagine the average member of Congress understanding the correction of the problems that have developed because the derivatives market is becoming unraveled? So no, there's very little understanding of the nature of it, because they're limiting their thoughts to a credit crunch, which means that some people have lost their credit rating. And that's good, because why keep loaning to people that don't have a good credit rating? People who have good ratings can still borrow money and buy a car. People who have overspent and overborrowed, like the U.S. government, they're going to have trouble, and we are having trouble. But we have to deal with the nature of government and why we spend so much money.
Ron Paul, certainly a favorite on this hour. Every time we have you on, we certainly get a lot of people responding. And we'll check some of those responses in just a little bit when we go to our Twitter board and MySpace and Facebook as well.